trenutno smo svedoci dosta sudskih procesa u kojima su se uglavnom mlađe žene obratile sudu zato što su bile silovane.
Because it's a big deal currently in this those geographies that women are speaking out about being victims of sexual violence, some like 9-10 years later, and they are usually accused about what they have been doing.
I onda još dva pokušaja silovanja koje sam doživjela u javnom prostoru. Pa sam pomislila da bi možda bilo dobro da to ispričam, jer će tu biti neke devojke i devojčice i mlade žene, da ih ohrabrim zbog toga što mislim da treba biti jako hrabar da bi se u takvoj ekstremnoj životnoj situaciji spasli.
Still, and I've been keeping it really for myself for 30 years.
Ali reći ću vam, ni jedan od ova četiri slučaja ja nisam prijavila policiji. Jednostavno, tada nisam o tome razmišljala. Shvatate, šta da prijavite? Neko je pokušao da vas napadne, ali nije vas silovao. A mogu misliti da mi se to, ne daj Bože, desilo, da li bih onda otišla?
Croatian food, like you can find on the markets, but actually this food came from Latin America after the 500 years ago.
And I bring like a original chipotle that here like a lot of people tell me, yeah, Mexicans love chili, but honestly that's not chili what you show me, like to me that's a Mexican chili that I ate every day in Mexico.
So I have pancetta from tomato, banana, potato, and some memories from my travels.
And when I was in Rome, my grandma passed away like 2 years ago. So I have this for my grandma.
So I think like as what I learned of my performance is that I was speaking a lot. So I and then I was going to have this opportunity to explain what I did. Yeah, it was basically very emotional for me.
Well, I embroidered today is like the funds that Croatian government asked me if I want to live here.
I izabrala sam Rivo jer za mene ta riba nekako novo, recimo kulturološki novo. Ljudi zapravo piju kavu, sunčuju se, ali zapravo oni gledaju ko prolazi. Jer niko, skoro niko ne sjedi s druge strane i gleda ko pije kavu s njim. Stavila sam, htjela sam zvati sve stvari koji zapravo ja i svi mi ono, pozivala da svi mogu se dojavati. Neke stvari nosimo kao, može biti nakit ili dodatak ili nešto, jer nekako osjećala sam da u društvu puno puta se smatrala žena kao samo taj dodatak koji taj vođa obitelj ima sa strane. Ne znamo koje su njene strasti, koji su njene možda snovi.
And I didn't really think about it, and I didn't really think what the priest was saying, what was going on. I took it not deep enough. But it seems like my body was appropriating some of the values.
Pozima vas da otkupite svoje grijehe budućke žene kršćanstva i da sve pogriješe savjest koju nam je ovaj patrijarhat nanio, da otkupite i da ponovno vratite svoju seksualnost, svoje tijelo i svoje oslobođenje sebi, tako da mi operete noge i prihvatite ulogu Marije Magdalene. jer feminizam oprašta i dopušta.
Which I didn't realize, because at the time where you need to be the most sexual person, it was kind of lukewarm for me. I felt pressure to liberate myself, and it was kind of difficult. So when I left my home, and when I stopped going to the church, and when I moved towards like more liberal communities, my sexuality just started coming right.
A backpack. When I was pregnant at home, I thought about the things, the objects that I interacted with in the last few days, and I kind of tried to track those. And the motivation was also kind of presenting this nomad life that a lot of circus artists experience, of not having like a permanent home and needing to leave your place of staying very often. And especially for me as a circus artist in Croatia who wants to get professional circus education, I have zero access to that in Croatia, so I have to leave my country to get professional education in my discipline.
Emphasize the displacement of us as an organization and platform workers. So we took the signs. It is a form of displacement women that is often used in Tanja's performances. And we put a displaced organization with the question mark. And we chose two places, one in the city center that you saw, and this is another one that was listed on the city's open call for renting spaces. So we were actually standing in front of it.
Same with me, I'm here like mopping, working, writing projects, fixing light fixtures, etc. And that's what every person that does with culture management or art production has to deal with. We have to know everything, and you kind of lose your identity or motivation throughout that whole struggle with logistics and making everything perfect for somebody else. So that's the concept that I was like talking about, all those different chores that you have to do, and lose a bit of yourself in the whole process.